So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon if you are coming here for the first time, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions, and you can also ask any doubt here, right? And we have launched our crash course, so you can avail the 40% discount by using the coupon code CRASH40 on all the crash courses. So do visit to the anujindal.in. So let's move ahead to the very first question, which says, what is the total reduction in percentage in residue burning events in Punjab, Haryana and UP together as per the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare? So guys, this question number 1 and question number 2 is based on a scheme which is known as the Scheme for Promotion of Agricultural Mechanization for In-Situ Management of Crop Residue. Jo crop residue hai, uske in-situ management ke liye, this scheme was launched for promotion of farm mechanization taki jo crop residue hai, uska in-situ management kiya ja sake, alright? And this was in news. This was in news because Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare has said that in the year 2020 in Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh together, the crop residue burning events has been declined by 30% as compared to 2016. If we compare the crop residue burning events with the year 2016, so in the year 2020, the events have been declined by 30%. Okay. But if you talk about the individual reduction in these three states, so for Punjab, the reduction is 22.7%, for Haryana it's 63.8%, while for Uttar Pradesh it's 52.01%. So you should remember the individual reduction also. This is not very heavy data, you can easily remember it, alright? And now let's talk about this scheme. So the scheme, guys, was launched in the year 2018 up to 2020-21, which means the financial year 2021 tak ke liye isko launch kiya tha. And basically isko ek saal pehle launch kiya gaya tha, then it was extended up to the financial year 2021. And it was launched with an objective to address the problem of air pollution which is due to the stubble burning cases in Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and Delhi. Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and Delhi, char jagahon ke liye this scheme was launched by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare from the central government, and also to prevent the loss of nutrients and soil microorganism, and also to promote in situ management of these crop residue taki unko jalana na pade, unka in situ management kar diya jaye aur jisse air pollution reduce ho sake, alright? It was launched, as I told you, in the year 2018 up to the financial year 2021, and till now 1726.67 crore have been provided by the central government, and this is a central sector scheme, which means all the funding, the 100% funding is from the central government side, alright? So I hope you can easily answer these two questions now. So what is the total reduction in percentage in residue burning events in Punjab, Haryana and UP together? So it's 30%. Option A, 30% will be the correct answer. Okay, and question number 2. Consider the following statements regarding the scheme for promotion of agricultural mechanization. Okay, and you have to identify the incorrect statement regarding this scheme. Okay, so statement 1 is, the scheme was implemented for Punjab, Haryana and UP only. So not only for these three states, but also for Delhi. So this statement, guys, is incorrect, okay? Kyunki Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh aur Delhi, char states aur UTs ke liye isko launch kiya tha. It was launched in 2016. No, that was not 2016. It 2018 when it was launched, alright? And it is a centrally sponsored scheme with funding ratio of 60:40 between the center and state. So is it a centrally sponsored scheme? No, it is a central sector scheme, alright? It is a central sector scheme and 100% funding is provided by the central government, okay, which means all the statements are incorrect and we have to identify the incorrect statements only. Therefore, option E, all are incorrect, will be the correct answer, all right and now let's move ahead to question number 3, which can be asked in your one marker. Which IIT has come up with a new process to generate hydrogen from water at low cost? Pani se hydrogen banane ka ek naya process is IIT ne design kiya hai, and the name of the process is what? Sulfur iodine thermochemical hydrogen cycle. This is the name of this process, and of course you don't have to go in detail of this process, just remember the name of the process is what? Sulfur iodine hydrochemical thermochemical hydrogen cycle and it has been developed from by the researchers of IIT Delhi. So option B, IIT Delhi here will be the correct answer, and this is very important question. This can be asked in your one marker. Okay, and now let's move ahead to question number 4, which is the last question for today. And guys, let me tell you ki aajkal jo news hai wo bahut kam hai, because we all know पार्लियामेंट का सेशन चल रहा है, तो पीआईबी में जनरली जो न्यूज है वो केवल रिटन रिप्लाईज के हैं जो भी मिनिस्टर्स हमारे सबमिट करते हैं. सो देर आर वेरी लेस न्यूज दीज डेज, तो जितनी भी हैं पढ़ लेते हैं. ओके, इन विच थ्री डिफेंस पीएसयूज अमंग द फॉलोइंग पीएसयूज द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट हैज अनाउंस्ड द डिसइन्वेस्टमेंट. इन 5 में से कौन से 3 डिफेंस पीएसयू है जिसमें गवर्नमेंट ने डिसइन्वेस्टमेंट अनाउंस कर दिया है. रिमेंबर ये जो डिसइन्वेस्टमेंट अनाउंस हुआ है इसमें परसेंटेज वगैरह भी गवर्नमेंट ने नहीं बताई है. They have just announced that okay, we will do disinvestment in these 3 defense PSUs, and the name of these defense PSUs are: number 1 is BEML Limited, which is nothing but Bharat Earth Movers Limited. Then we have GRSE Garden Ridge Shipbuilders and Engineers Limited, and this is the first company in India to provide 100 warships. ये पहली company in India की जिसने 100 warships बनाए हैं for the Indian Navy and ICGS. And its 100th warship was LCU L56, and LCU stands for Landing Craft Utility. It was given to Indian Navy ko diya gaya tha ye LCU L56, and this was its 100th warship that was provided by GRSE, and its current chairperson is Mr. VK Saxena, and it is headquartered in Kolkata. And the third defense PSU jisme disinvestment announced hua hai, that is Midhani stands for Mishra Dhatu Nigam Limited, and this is the same company जिसने भाभा कवच बनाने में हेल्प करी थी, along with Ordnance Factory Board in Jabalpur and BARC भाभा Atomic Research Center. And Midhani's current chairperson is Dr. Sanjay Kumar Jha. Alright, so which means we have first, fourth, and fifth BEML Limited, GRSE, and Midhani. So these 3 defense PSUs में अब जो है disinvestment किया जाएगा by the government. Therefore, option C. Option C, 1, 4, and 5 will be the correct answer. All right, and guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. And before ending the session, let me announce one thing here. कि आज शाम को 8 बजे there will be a session on the government scheme. जो भी पुरानी government schemes हैं उनका session होगा. And I will take 3 sessions on the old government scheme. 2 में हम 2 से 2 government scheme में we will revise the पुरानी government scheme. And in 1 session, I will bring to you the questions. Related to government scheme that can be asked in the descriptive exam. Okay, जो descriptive वाला pattern है उसमें government scheme के किस तरीके के question पूछे जा सकते हैं, we will discuss that. But today at 8 PM I'll join you with the government scheme, old government scheme session. All right. So thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.